Ladies and gentlemen, we've been telling you that we're going to talk to Prince. Good morning, Prince.
Good morning.
Whoa! Oh,
listen to that voice. Welcome to CHUM FM, and thanks so much for talking to us. We're so excited about your concerts this weekend.
I'm excited, too. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, and I understand that in each case, and I've seen you many times, you change up the show. So what you decide to do tonight might be a little bit different than maybe tomorrow night. Am I right on that?
Absolutely. There's a lot of songs we know now, and it's up to the audience. If they give us energy, then we return it.
Wow.
So do you just kind of make up a set as you go? Like if it's like, you know what, I feel like doing a little Red Corvette tonight. Will you break into it, or do you actually have a set list in front of you?
We have a set list, but there's so many songs that, you know, you vibe off the audience. If they're really excited, then sometimes I'll switch it up and just start the kick drum pattern, which usually leads into any number of fast tunes that we do. Yeah.
We played your brand new song yesterday. We were the first radio station in the world, and we thank you for that, for allowing us to be the first to play it. A fantastic song, got some great response to it immediately.
Oh, great. It's an older track that I did, well, new to people who haven't heard it, but it was recorded during the 1999 sessions, and
wow,
the album 1999, so that would be 82. Somewhere around there.
Well, it's really got such a great funky sound to it, and I thought it sounded like a kickback to some of your earlier stuff. We played it again early this morning, I was mentioning that, and I said I wondered if it was from your vault, because I still hear to this day that you have hundreds and hundreds of unreleased songs in there.
Yeah, that was the plan. You know, we did a lot of music as much as we could back during that time, so that it would be, you know, just coasting during this period. So I just pull out some of these tracks from time to time. We either play them live or give them to the people, you know.
Mm-hmm. Now, was it completely produced that far back, or did you tweak it in some way?
Well, with me, you know, because I play all the instruments and do all the voices, I'm still going to do basically the same thing. So I still have the same machines and instruments that I used back then. But I have three different versions of it. And this is the first one to come out. I'll release all of them eventually.
So when you released it just recently, you didn't add anything to it or change it in any way from when it was first done?
We changed the words around. Mm-hmm. You know, I feel differently, and being one of Jehovah's Witnesses, I don't use some of the same language or themes that I used to. But at the same time, it is the same person, so, you know, you get an updated feel to it.
Wow. On some sites they say, they ask people what their favorite Prince songs are of all time. What are your favorite songs that you have written and performed?
The next one.
That's a good answer. I love it. I love it.
Well, yeah, we're working on our new guitar player, Andy Allo's record now, and I can't stop singing her songs. So I look forward to seeing that come out soon, and I always enjoy the favorites, too, and revamping them and trying them different ways with different musicians, you know, because you always hear new things with them.
And Andy is featured on Extra Lovable.
Yeah.
Yeah. So can you tell us what we can expect at your concerts tonight and tomorrow night? Anything, any little teases you want to give us?
Oh, well, you know, we live to get funky, so it's going to be pretty powerful from song one. And like I say, with the audience, as long as they're there, we'll stay. We have enough material to play 3-4 hours, you know.
I know you do. It's amazing.
I hope you do play 3 or 4 hours.
Well, you say that until you get up the next morning.
That's true. I had no voice the last time we were here. You brought on Nelly Furtado on stage, and you kept playing and playing, and I thought I had no voice the next day. I had such a great time.
I haven't seen her in a minute. What's up with her?
She is working on a new album that's coming out in the spring, and she sings your praises all the time.
Oh, yeah, she's a sweetheart.
Yeah, she always asks when we've talked to you last, and now we can tell her.
Yeah.
Well, you know, for the first time today. So during these shows, you've invited a lot of celebrities to come up on stage and jam with you. I know Naomi Campbell and Whoopi Goldberg and Jamie Foxx and Alicia Keys and Leighton Meester and Sherry Shepherd. So I was wondering maybe if there wouldn't be a surprise tonight, like because you're in Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know James Brown, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, sadly, he's no longer with us, but his right-hand man, Maceo Parker, is going to be joining us tonight.
Oh, wow.
Is he really? Maceo. Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was with him for years and years.
Yeah, if you ever get the chance, go see him, because it's just like watching James. It's got the same power. They come from the same school, you know. And I don't know. I'm just in town now, so after the party tonight, we should, you know, hook up some more folks.
Now, you have quite a strong Toronto connection. Everybody knows that you once lived here for a period of time. What was it about Toronto that drew you here?
I really dug the cosmopolitan aspect of it, and the fact that, you know, they were so anti-establishment.
Yeah.
I saw something recently about the detainee at Guantanamo, and it was just powerful. I watched the whole thing and was sad at the same time. I know we need to talk about these things, and, you know, we're all the same thing once you look at it deeper, and we got to get along now. It's time.
It is time. So when you're finished the show tonight or tomorrow night, you don't just say goodnight, everybody, and call it a day, do you?
Oh, no, no, no.
What happens? Tell us what happens after we go home. What do you do?
Well, tonight we're going over to Ame, which is a spot that DJ Rashida put together for us, and we're going to jam over there.
Oh, my gosh, that's good. Thank you for the thank you for telling us that.
I think there will be a crowd there now.
That's
why,
just
yeah, there's people listening to this.
Yeah, of course there are.
Just a little thing called Planet Earth.
We're talking with Prince. By the way, I met the gardener who used to landscape your property when you lived in Toronto, and he said to say hello.
Oh, here we go.
And we've had a lot of people connect from all over the world knowing that you were going to be on with Chum FM today. Is there anything you want to say to your fans?
Well, I just want them to come out to the shows, because it's a lot different than before. Mm-hmm. It's longer, louder, and a lot more of a party atmosphere. I was on my way back to this place, and I've been looking forward to being here, so it's so much fun. It's a good night out.
All right.
I think one of the reasons we all have so much respect for you, too, is because of the mystery that surrounds you. You know, we never see you in the tabloids. And how do you keep such a low profile in this day and age?
Well, I live in Minnesota.
I guess that would help.
There you go.
It's pretty chill there.
Yeah. You're
still in Duluth, or are you actually moving to the big city now?
I'm in, I like that. I'm in Minneapolis.
Of course you are. And still a big Vikings fan?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Prince, we understand that Live Nation has donated some tickets tonight for members of Epilepsy Toronto to go to this concert for Saturday night's concert.
That was real sweet of them.
Yeah. And you admitted, or you mentioned the fact some time ago that you were born with epilepsy, but you've overcome it.
Yeah. Recently, though, I've been having a couple bouts with vertigo, so hopefully it won't come back. Mm-hmm. But a lot of kooky people had it, so I don't feel so bad.
Okay, all right.
Well, it's been a real pleasure talking to you. We've been promoting this and talking about it all morning, and we've had people worldwide tweeting about the fact that you were going to be on with us today, so we really appreciate
Such
it.
Such a buzz. And thank you so much for continuing to make great music and touring, because it's just such a pleasure to talk to you, but even more so to see you perform.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Prince.
All right.